we have it. Great Britain versus Australia, the test match series everyone's been waiting for. At the present time, we have the English side marching around to the starting line. Here you can see them, the bikes being pushed ahead of them. Ken McKinlay, the manager of the English team, and the captain, Nigel Boocock. Here we have them walking around to the starting line as I speak, and I think it's fairly opportune. The Channel 10 Sports Director, Jim Shepherd, have a few words with Ken McKinlay and Nigel Boocock. Here's the opposition all the way from England. The captain of the English side, Nigel Boocock, and the manager of the English side, Ken McKinlay. We'll start with the captain, if you don't mind, Nigel. You've had a couple of runs on the Sydney showdown track now. Honestly, how did you go, and what do you think the chances are tonight?
I came out quite late, and I thought it was a very, very good track, and I'm sure that it isn't going to affect any of the English teams tonight. Better not do, anyway.
Well, Ken, in the pits, you've got all the boys ready. He's the manager of the side. You've been out here many, many times. We know this is a great side. Do you tip an English victory?
Without a bit of contradiction, yes.
I think it will be a very good meeting, but I'm sure we will win. I'm very confident. Now, during the week, you've been quoted many times as saying that the only riders that really worry you in the Australian side are Jim Airey and Gordon Gasco. Now, do you think that's a little bit fair? Because many of the boys do go very well on this tank.
Well, I'm going on performances overseas. I've raced against both Jim and Gordon here. I know with the door light to the other lad.
Well, I don't read them at all, I'm sorry.
Well, that's a nice, you know, frank comment.
Nigel, you would have seen a few of them in practice during the week. Now, what did you think of some of them?
I was quite impressed with them. I was quite surprised. I noticed that several of the unknown Australian riders were going on equally as quick, and perhaps even quicker than some of our boys. I admitted our boys were on board the machines, which I must say to you as well, that the machines were totally unsuited to them. They weren't even like the machine that they have in England.
One final thing, Ken, obviously you just had a sit-down session with Nigel and the rest of the boys. Have you planned any special tactics or just treat this as a match as you would have the British League match?
Get out that gate and do as fast as you can.
Well, we're looking forward to a great match. We've heard so much about Nigel, the rest of the boys have seen you so often, Ken, they know all about you. So all I can do is wish you best. Nigel first, and Ken all the very best, and may the best Nigel.
Thank you very much.
There's strong words from the captain of the English side, Nigel Boocock, and the team manager, Ken McKinlay. Now, the Australian side has come onto the circuit, led out by their manager, Lionel Levy, and the captain, Jim Airey. And now, for a comment from both of them before this test match gets underway, an interview now with Mike Raymond talking to both Lionel Levy and Jim Airey. With me at the moment, the Australian team manager, Lionel Levy, to my right, and over here, the Australian team captain, the boy we hope can pull it off for Australia tonight, and that's Jim Airey. First of all, Lionel, congratulations on your appointment.
Thank you, Mike.
And Jim, what else can we say? You've done so very, very well here this season. You should be back from England. What do you think? I know this is a silly question this time, but what do you think of our chances before the lights come on and the first race is up?
Well, all the boys are keen, and they're all out there, they're just been talking to them all, and they're all keen and ready to try their best.
I'm sure they will.
The team's terrific, and they all want to see if they have a test, so I don't know, you can't forecast something, but they'll be all right.
Now, how does it feel? Just turn around to the camera here a little, Jim. How does it feel to wear the kangaroo for the first time, representing Australia in the test of your hometown?
It's a great honour to invite you. I don't know what to say.
Well, I know you're pretty teed up at the moment, so I won't hold you up anymore, Jim. I know you're waiting to work back on your bike, so good luck to you in the test tonight coming up very, very shortly. Now, Lionel, before Jim goes away, I know you're going back to the dressing room. Being the Australian team manager, this is something new for you, a former international and one of Australia's top scorers in matches in the past against England.
Well, I really think we'll win tonight, Mike. I think Jim will lead them on a victory. And if there is any weak link in the team, and we bring our reserve in, well, I think that he will really ride to win, and I think that he could be our winning point man to clinch victory tonight. Although we cannot underestimate the English riders, but I'm sure that they cannot underestimate our team either.
Well, I know you're a bit nervous talking on television, Lionel. Of course, everyone knows the name Lionel Levy.
The last test match here at the Sydney Showground back in 1960, one of the top scorers for Australia, captain of that state, Lionel, and you're all tonight. Congratulations on your appointment, and best of luck to Australia and all the boys.
Thank you, Mike.
Lionel Levy speaking with us, the captain, and also Jim Airey, the captain team manager combination of the Australian side tonight. Well, there you have the Australian side of things, Jim Airey and also Lionel Levy. At the present time, leading up to the first hit race, we have both teams walking around to the starting line where they'll be formally introduced to the big crowd here at the Sydney Showdown Speedway tonight. Well in excess, as we speak at the present time, of nearly 28,000 people. A huge crowd here at the Sydney Showdown. Channel 10 on the spot, and historic telecast here because this is the first telecast of an international speedway test, and it's Channel 10 in Sydney bringing it to you.